morning, hello to you all. Welcome to the show. It's Tuesday the 7th of October 2014. My, even October's going quickly at the moment.
It is a bit.
Hey Lisa, good morning.
Good, I'm really well, thanks. How are you?
Yeah, fantastic.
I think that was the question you used to ask me. Or sort of roughly that.
I think you
that.
Preempted the question.
Just a tad.
We're just saving time.
Well, yeah. We know each other so well now. You
exactly.
Just kind of, you get rid of verbs
finish
and adjectives.
Each other's
and
sentences.
Exactly.
What?
Good morning to you, Sylvia.
Good morning, Carl and Lisa. Sylvia. Benny, how
are
you?
It'll be rather exhausting at times, you two.
What?
Do you think?
Yeah, simple, how are
so,
you?
Well. Why don't you just get out then? Get off the show.
Meantime, we'll just get on with the weather.
I don't want to read the score.
I'll do
come
that.
Back.
You might have to.
It's not hard. It's like two items.
Just, he doesn't bother with nouns and verbs and stuff either.
Tuesday Stitcher. Tuesday Stitcher.
The director of the program, Brian Newton, who is a great director, just said to me before we came over, get rid of that juice. That's ugly, that juice on the desk. So I've got rid of it accidentally. And it's gone down onto the computers, underneath.
It looks like someone had a big knife.
Maybe that's my excuse on Sylvia's shoe.
Yep.
You don't often see behind the scenes here, do you?
See, we were also told that we had to take stuff like this off the desk. And as Carl and I said, every great Aussie kitchen has bags of stuff.
Bags of stuff.
On. Mm. Yeah, that we want to, you know, be like you guys at home this morning. You got stuff everywhere. Haven't quite cleaned up from last night. So this is what happens when we clean up. We should never clean up.
No.
Can you clean up this, darling?
No. No, darling. No, darling. No,
isn't that a woman's job, though?
I do enough of that stuff at home, I can promise
you. Come on. Come on. You've got to have a crack.
Even the boys
You've got to have a crack.
Even the boys think that is not
so
on.
So PC,
Thank
Lisa.
Thank you, gentlemen.
Get with the program.
Thank you. Love you, boys.
This is bad, Forda.
You know what's particularly bad? You've ruined a
$100
note.
No, I found a hundy. We should have done clean up long ago.
Yeah, wash that baby out.
There's hundies under the desk.
Wow.
They're falling out of your pocket.
And pineapples.
There's probably all sorts of stuff under there we didn't know was there.
You know, look, I think that's been there since Lebo was here.
Yeah.
Little ashtray down there.
He doesn't smoke anymore. Which is
Ray
good.
Martin's hair sits in the back there.
Oh, that's good.
What else have we got? Anyway, we probably shouldn't delve too deep.
No, it could be all sorts of secrets that we don't even want to know about. But lovely to see you clean
up. Could write
up
a book,
there,
I guess.
All right.
What a turnaround from Derby Day, where the poncho was the fashion item of choice.
Very windy and rainy and stormy.
It was miserable, wasn't it? The weather was, but people looked magnificent. Sylvia.
No, yeah,
Sylvia
was
named among them.
I had pants on, so I didn't have to worry about the big gusts of wind like everyone else at the track.
We're glad you had pants on, Sylvia.
She had a very nice pantsuit.
Yes. A pantsuit.
I'm glad
to be
you
clear.
Clarified. Yeah.
I mean, look.
Yeah, it's always wise to keep your pants on. And what did Jess Campbell
say? It's always good to keep your
pants on. Stop it. Shoes on, too, is the key as well.
Yes, shoes. So, Jess is coming up a little bit later in the program talking about how women, when they get to the end of the race, they generally have their shoes off and they've had too much drink and how it's pretty disgraceful. Mm.
And they should leave their pants on, too.
Yes, exactly.
Always leave your pants on.
A little bit later...
Dickie knows all about that.
Speaking of...
He has a very special competition coming up, Dickie. Have a look.
The creator of the classic board game Operation is in need of some medical attention of his own, but he's struggling to pay for it. So we wish him all the best in getting to $25,000.
That was one of the great board games.
Still is.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Haven't played it in a while. Connect Four.
We owe him a lot for introducing that to the world, so let's get behind him.
So many surgeons have gone on with it after that.
Crowdfunding for surgery.
That board game has inspired many young children to go on to be doctors.
Yeah, exactly.
Possibly.
Or criminals.
What about Mousetrap? Anyone have that?
Oh, that was good.
Yeah.
We weren't allowed
Twister.
To have that.
Did you have Twister?
Twister.
Yeah, Twister we were allowed to have.
What about Hungry Hippo?
No, we weren't allowed that.
That was too expensive.
Too noisy. Mousetrap. Mum just said, if you want to play it, you watch the ad.
Yeah.
The ad was fantastic. Do you remember
it was
the ad?
Very good.
So poor. That was a really good
ad. Anything with too many parts or batteries, we weren't allowed to have. No.
We were so poor, we had a mouse trap next to this hole in the wall that the mouse lived in.
And that was what
you were saying. That was your mouse
trap. But no cheese to go in it.
Here comes Carl. Where did you score those from?
Well, they've been sent in by Stevie.
Oh.
So it's nice, isn't it?
Wow.
Do you know what I love about when you see cherries?
Yeah.
Christmas is just around the corner.
Yeah, ain't that the truth.
Yeah. They make a great earring.
Don't they? Mm. Cherry earrings. Mm. A bit of cherry. Yeah. It also reminds me that I've got to go start going out and thinking about the Christmas presents for the kids.
Yeah. Yeah. Ah, right.
The ones that we get, not Santa, of course.
Mm. Your wife has to go out and start thinking about Christmas presents.
Gee, that's sexist, isn't it?
Carl does it. He does a lot of that stuff.
That's so sexist.
Mm. Oh, well, I have a bit of inside information, don't I?
Do you? You can't keep giving them Today Show mugs and stuff like that.
Why not? I gave them the clock last year.
Because they've got all
that stuff.
Have you done the hats yet?
Yeah.
That was a few years ago.
They've got all Channel 9 merchandise now.
Yeah.
What about when you gave them umbrellas, the Channel 9 umbrellas?
Dad loved that.
Good for a rainy day.
Dad loved that.
Those cherries are great. Wow.
They probably paid for it too.
Have you ever been to one of the Target openings when they do
it? I reported on one once. It was absolute mayhem. Mm. I didn't even bother going near the racks.
Well, I did
mayhem.
I did the Stella McCartney one once. Never again.
No, that was the one I reported on.
Was it? Oh. A woman almost ate me alive because I picked up a dress that she'd put down. But I didn't know.
Don't you hate the way they get their elbows out when they come across?
I know. Yeah. And if you're
trying their limbs
on the same
to themselves,
stuff as
this
them.
Is very. It's so short.
I know. I've come down a little bit. It's not quite that short. That's so much better.
Mm, shopping.
Can I just point out Carl's pants this morning? While we're in fashion mode, these are stunning contribution to this morning's fashions on the field, Carlos.
You know what happened?
They're very good.
They're actually white pants, but they got washed with Sylvia's dress.
Yeah.
Don't you hate when that happens?
It's going to be hard to explain that one.
It's not too.
Indeed. All right, well, after the break, time for Celeb Buzz with Richard Reed. What's going on, Richard?
Lisa just asking a question. Fire extinguishers that she's got at home, yes. Do they have an expiry date?
They do, and it'll be stamped on them.
Right,
and,
okay.
And yeah, all extinguishers have an expiry date and do need regular servicing.
Okay, Lisa's about 15 years old.
Yeah, time for a new one.
Yeah. we're talking about the extinguisher, not the husband.
Yeah. Well, I suppose the size of the husband, you just throw him on anything
exactly.
And it'll put it out.
Smothers it.
He'd be good like
I'm
that,
I'm talking
actually.
About fires here, Lisa.
Yeah. They should throw him out of the Elvis choppers too. Just...
I shouldn't be laughing because I'm going to get into trouble.
No, we love Pete. We love Pete.
We do love Pete.
He's a stallion.
One.
Yeah. Can we have some more music
and
to the floor, please?
In. And bend, and up, bend, up, bend, up, bend, and one, up, out, up, out, up, out, up, up, sway, stretch, in, stretch, in, stretch,
in,
stretch, and bend.
Don't let them in, don't let them see. Be the good girl you always have to be. Conceal, don't feel, don't let them know.
So you get for just holding.
Well, now they know.
You're still winning and you're not even singing.
Let it go, let it go. Can't hold it back anymore.
Let it go, let it go. Turn my back and slam the door. And hey!
Look, sadly, we have to leave it there, but we will be back and we'll reveal the winner a little bit later in the show.
Do you know the thing is, she's never far from our thoughts, that Christy Brinkley.
Yeah. Right?
Never far from our thoughts.
Yeah.
It's almost as if she's here in the studio with us sometimes, that Christy Brinkley.
Yeah.
You know?
Just,
yes.
Why is that?
Yeah.
Why is that?
Just, I don't know. Anyway. Thank you, Richard. Yeah.
She is right there in the studio. Oh. Arch brow.
Why you?
G-G! It's double G!
Here comes the sun.
Summer's almost here. Oh, nice hit, Fordo.
Come on.
Not
come
really. On. You can do better than that, Fordo.
Oh.
Where was the keeper?
Go out with a bang, big fella.
Yeah, is it? I tell you what, this is almost like a hula hoop, this one.
Oh, Sylvia. Mate. Oh, Carl. Hey. Off. Go.
Red card.
Go early.
We'll be on to you, boys.
Say sorry. Are you okay?
That's all right.
You okay,
Liz?
We'll be okay.
Is my client okay here?
It's okay. He's not welcome back, but that's
sorry,
all right.
That's all right.
No worries.